Good morning, guys. Sorry about the glare. I'm on a walk, but I just have not seemed to find quiet time in my house to make a vlog in the past couple days. So here I am on my walk. Good morning. Just wanted to do a check-in. Good updates coming near the end of the round. Tomorrow is LIW for me and David. Actually, his might be today. Anyway, things are going very well. I finally broke my stall. I believe the stall was like a 4 or 5 day stall last week. And I vlogged about it, I think last Wednesday. And I was thinking it was either antibiotics or ovulation. I still actually am on the antibiotics and for a sinus infection, 10 days of it. But honestly, guys, I'm chalking it up to ovulation, and here's why. AI, good old I, if you know her, suggested that I go on a really long walk on that Wednesday and drink some apple cider vinegar. And I did. I did both. And I'll say that that worked for the next day because, well, I've been doing it every day since just to get in the habit because I know that apple cider vinegar is good for you. The walks I had really been doing anyways, but next day, Thursday, I definitely broke that stall with a little bit of a release. And then each day since, there have been small releases, but they are releases. But the reason I think that the stall was caused by ovulation is because my pattern is when I'm ovulating, I generally tend to have some type of a stall, and then literally that following whole week, every day is a release. So that's how my body works. That's the really great thing about HCG is that you're paying so much attention to your body during the protocol and what's affecting what, that you can actually really nail it down. So it's really cool. What else? So I'm down about, I think, 12 pounds from preload weight, and I'll take it. 12 pounds before the holidays? I mean, hello? What other protocol can one go on and say that they've released 12 pounds in 3 weeks? Not many. But I'll tell you guys, it definitely had a lot to do with the HCG. Not the amount I released, because in looking back at all of my, you know, notes that I used to take, I think I'm like the weight that I'm losing is pretty consistent with what I've always lost. The only difference is that I'm not miserable. I'm not hungry in between meals. Like I've said in every vlog, this HCG is so good. And it just changes the whole mentality of this protocol. If I weren't going away next Friday or this Friday, I would be continuing. And I could definitely go 40 days, like no question. Yes, it gets a little tedious and redundant. But it's worth it. I totally feel the inflammation in my body, going down, which is really, I don't know about you guys, but I don't have any type of autoimmune issues whatsoever that I'm aware of, and I hope I don't. And if any of you do, I just am so sorry, because I know that that's a lifelong battle. But I definitely suffer with inflammation. I think a lot of it has to do with just extra weight that we keep on and stuff like that on our bodies. So when you start to release that weight, it really makes a difference. You know, even 10, 12 pounds for sure, you notice it. Another thing I wanted to talk about was, if you're following the original pounds and inches protocol, there's, you know, all this talk about really staying perfect on protocol and watching the products that you even use on your body, because our skin absorbs all of these things like lotions and oils. I just want to tell you, I've never really strictly followed that. In past rounds, I mean, maybe my first couple rounds for sure, I tried to be careful with that. And even massage. I mean, the original protocol says do not get massages. I've had 2 massages this round. I had a massage yesterday. It was a Thai-Swedish combo with hot stones. It was amazing. But let me just tell you, like, she was getting in there, and I thought for sure that there'd be a good chance that there might be a gain on the scale today, but there wasn't. And she used oils. So just listen to your body, you guys. If you need a massage, go get a massage. If you're scared to get a manicure because they're going to use cuticle oil, go get your manicure. Go get your pedicure. Treat yourself. Don't worry about the fine little minutiae, because you know what? It's all about consistency. And I say that because of all the things I just mentioned. And also, I've been POP this whole protocol. POP, for anyone who doesn't know, means perfect on protocol. Except for yesterday, last night. And I think I went to a party every night this weekend. I've been out. And really, the only temptation that I had was last night. And you want to know what it was? Ribs. Our friends got amazing smoked barbecue from this place that I had never been to. I couldn't not eat it. I had gone there already eating my dinner, so I was like trying to be good. No joke, I probably had 4 ribs. They were so good. I thought for sure the level of sodium in those ribs was just gonna do me in, but I was okay with it because I know I had done so well and I knew that the consistency was what was gonna matter. But guess what? The ribs plus the massage still had a release. And so yes, it's consistency and where you are in your cycle. I'll add that, because I believe being the week after ovulation for me is a good week. So I'm glad I'm ending on this week, because this is my week I usually do release well. Anyways, I think I had more notes, but since I'm not home, I can't remember what they are. But here's the plan. Tomorrow is last injection, and then 72 hours brings me to Friday. Friday we're going on vacation, going skiing for 2 weeks. So I'll be going into P3. Shouldn't be too hard. I feel like it's very easy to eat out in restaurants on P3. And we're staying at my parents' house, so I'll have all the food I need for whenever I need it. And what else? And then we'll go into P4. David's tempted to, he's still talking about all the yummy foods he's missing and wants to eat. So hopefully I'll be able to contain him and, you know, show him that his 20-pound weight loss release was worth it. And let's not screw it up like this week. Maybe we can go a couple weeks at least. I don't know how strictly he will follow P3, and I don't know like how strictly he's going to weigh himself and stay within the 2-pound rule, but guys are different, you know, so much easier for them. Anyways, to all of you guys, happy holidays, happy everything, have safe, happy, healthy new year. I actually will vlog. I'm going to get David on here vlogging with me for our last final LIW vlog, so I got to get him to sit down with me and do that. So we will do that. It might be, I don't know when, but stay tuned. We'll be back. I know you all like us together, so I'll get him. Bye, everybody. Mwah.